everybody got fights. Yeah, but what they know what good advice was. Till they leave him lifeless. Another mama crying, it's another.
Meeting your season goal gives high rewards, but does come with risk.
Sacrifices. I know we can't continue living like this. And I never sell my soul because that's priceless.
Get ahead on your preparations for this week's game by setting up your game plan.
Save the children. Men is on the plot and I'm just revealing. The media just trying to make a villain. I just take the pain and paint a picture. Voices in my head, I hear the whispers when I feel this way. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless. And I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? It's just the way I feel. My been wasting so long.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. It's the first game of this young man's NFL career, and it's usually the case with rookie cornerbacks just starting out. You have to think he'll be picked on early and often by opposing quarterbacks. It's the Saints going up against the Vikings.
It's one of the new jewels of the NFL, no doubt, as you get a look inside U.S. Bank Stadium here in Minneapolis. It can certainly get loud inside this building. And just a few moments ago when the Vikings were introduced, it was downright shaking in here. They're set for football as the Vikings get ready to do battle with the New Orleans Saints. Welcome in, everyone. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden and partner. Training camp over. Preseason over. It's time for week one.
And how much fun is that? No longer do we have to talk about who's going to make the team. The rosters are set. These guys now get to go out and play for real. No more of these preseason games. Now they're playing and the records count.
Bradford now to throw on first down. Open here, Adam Thielen. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there. Get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
Brandon, I think we can see early on they're making a concerted effort to get him the football. So to me, that means they like the matchup that they have. They feel like he's better than the guys that are covering him.
Two plays, two passes. We'll see if they go back to that well. And he's brought down. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Last year, New Orleans dead last, number 32 in passing defense. Something that was exploited game after game. You know, though, those guys are tired of hearing about it. Now they just want to fix it.
And you fix it with players playing better. We know that. But also you fix it with scheme. You look at what you have and say, can we play the style that we played in 2016? And you and I both know the New Orleans defensive staff. They like to be aggressive. They like to get after the quarterback, put their guys a lot of man coverage. Maybe we'll play a little more zone in 2017, get some of the pressure off of the back end of the defense.
Now And Charles, a couple extra defensive backs in here on third and one.
Not expecting them to run it at all.
They'll run here. It's Murray. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's... Forbath out to kick this one away. On the return, it's Ted Ginn Jr. And here come the Saints for their opening drive. With a run by Murray. Oh, he faked it with a juke. Now he's got some room. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. Boy, not what you want to see in quarter one of the new year. We'll be back. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. From the shotgun, it's Bradford. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
A second down throw for Bradford. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. Touchdown, Vikings! Stephon Diggs, 52 yards. Forbath out to kick this one away. This is taken at his 4. Good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Out now come the Vikings. They're starting to pull away with this one. Early on that first quarter, they didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times, it's just in a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways, but right now, you got to like what they're doing. They have put distance between themselves and their opponent.
Looking to add on here in the second quarter. Now a second down throw for Bradford, and this is going to be incomplete. He was looking for his tight end there, Kyle Rudolph, and it's third down.
When we talk with people about what we think the most important quality for an NFL quarterback to possess, what do people usually say?
Arm strength. He showed the arm strength there.
Yeah, pretty good bullet pass he threw, but he wasn't accurate, was he?
No.
Listen, you like mobility, but accuracy, first and foremost, is what a quarterback...